Jean Béliveau was my idol when I grew up. I met Jean when I was 10 years old, Quebec City Pee Wee Tournament. I scored a hat trick that day and Jean was there. We took a picture together. He was putting a hat on my head and he said, maybe one day we'll see you in the NHL.
Born in Thurso, Quebec, Guy Lafleur played with an elegance and natural talent reminiscent of his idol. He wore Béliveau's number 4 and shattered junior scoring records with the Quebec Remparts. The Canadiens held the first pick in the 1971 draft, and until draft day, there was some question as to whether they would select Lafleur or St. Catharines standout Marcel Dion.
From the Quebec Remparts, Guy Lafleur.
When you're a kid, your dream is to eventually play in the NHL and to play with your team, Montreal Canadiens, because they were the best and because of the chance of winning the Stanley Cup.
Nicknamed the Flower, Lafleur's start in Montreal was anything but easy.
He didn't have a great rookie season. It was fine, but it was certainly not to the standards that, you know, was imagined of him. In the second year, pretty much the same. The third year, pretty much the same.
The expectations were too high. He came as John Béliveau retired. They thought that Lafleur was coming in to replace Béliveau.
You don't replace a guy like that. Andrew Richard, Yvan Cournoyer were telling me one day, stop listening to everybody, just play your style. You'll get your confidence back, and that's what I did.
And the first time I see Guy Lafleur on the ice, I went back home and I said, wow, what a hockey player that guy is. So that was just a matter of time that Guy was going to be one of the best players in the NHL.
After those 3 years, he became the number one player in the league by a country mile.
In his fourth season, Lafleur netted 53 goals and 119 points, more than doubling his totals from the previous year. It was the first of 6 consecutive seasons with 50-plus goals and 100-plus points. During that time, Lafleur collected 3 straight scoring titles, 3 straight Lester B. Pearson Awards, and 2 Hart Trophies as MVP.
He was the Rocket Richard of the 70s for Montreal fans.
Everyone watched the way that this guy skated and scored goals, and he was who I really wanted to be.
He was exciting. He had one visual key that could describe that speed, and that was his hair.
Going up the right side 90 miles an hour, and that long hair going.
There were very few players who would actually lift you out of your seat. But when Lafleur took the puck and his hair was flying behind him, people literally got out of their seats.
The Canadiens won 4 straight Stanley Cups from 1976 to 1979. Lafleur won the Conn Smythe in 1977 and paced playoff scoring for 3 consecutive seasons.
He gives it into Lemaire, back to Lafleur. Oh!
He scored 518 goals with Montreal before retiring 19 games into the 1984-85 season, but made a comeback 4 years later with the New York Rangers.
I told them, just invite me to the training camp.
First scrimmage, goes to the right, takes a shot, far end, scores.
After a year in New York, he returned to Quebec to close out his career with the Nordiques.
When I was on the ice, I was home, because every time I was on the ice, I was the happiest guy in the world, especially wearing the Montreal Canadiens uniform.
Guy Lafleur's dream was to play for the Montreal Canadiens. He retired as the storied franchise's all-time leading scorer. His 1,246 points outrank a myriad of legends, including his childhood idol, John Béliveau.